Thank you for joining us today to celebrate our students' achievements and success. Before I introduce our graduates, I want to acknowledge some important individuals in our audience. This year marks Satterton Vantage Academy's 21st anniversary of providing educational and therapeutic services for students. Lakeside values and appreciates the partnership we have had with Satterton Area School District for many years. Here in the audience is Director of Pupil Services, Megan Zweibeck. Home and School Visitor, Rami Tressler. And Supervisor of Special Education, Matt Montagna. I truly cannot think of a finer group of individuals to work with, and I thank them for their partnership. Now I'd like to address the parents and family members of Vantage graduates. Your love and support for your child or family member is a strong foundation that helped our graduates find success that they're going to experience today. Thank you for your partnership this year as you work with the Vantage staff. Please join me in a round of applause for the parents and family members. Vantage staff, the love and care you have for your students is evident. You have worked tirelessly this year to provide excellent therapeutic and educational services to your students. Thank you for all you do. Now, please rise as we welcome our most important guests here today. I present to you the graduating class of 2023. Think you'd be here? Yeah, all right, this is great. Well, today is a beautiful day, and I have to say that the group before me is a beautiful group. Among this group of graduates are individuals with strong personalities. Justice and fairness are important to all of you. I have seen you support, care for, and encourage each other all this year. I have seen each of you show kindness and good character towards each other and your classmates. And I just want you to know that I truly feel joy and happiness for all of you. And I hope that you feel joy today too, because today's a new beginning for all of you. All of you have had hopes and dreams for your future, and today you are one step closer to achieving the life goals that you dream of. Graduates, all of you have a story. Your individual journey through childhood to make it to your high school graduation today. There were tears, obstacles, and tough times along the way. And some of you just told me recently that you never thought that you'd make it to graduation. But here you are. I just recently read that 1.2 million young people drop out of high school in the USA every year. That's a lot. I didn't realize that. But today, you are not part of that group. You are among the successful. All of you have unique gifts and talents that can make positive impact on our world. And today, your parents, family, and friends, we're all very proud of you. The Vantage staff and I want you to know how valuable you are. And at this time, Vantage staff are going to present some reflections on our graduates. Those staff giving reflections, please come to the front and make your remarks.
Good afternoon, my name is Darren Bacon. I'm a teacher at the Vantage Academy. And today I will be addressing my comments to John. You guys were worried, I know. So John has been with us for a while, But as a high school teacher, I only really got to know him when he came into high school. Really, when he was in middle school, all I knew about him is that every once in a while he would like put his legs behind his head. It was kind of weird, but I've enjoyed getting to know John as he came to high school. And John is a positive person. Even if the rest of the class is sleepy, I know John will be enthusiastic, friendly, and willing to chat. I can count on him to answer a question and get the ball rolling on discussions. And he's always ready to share a story. I've heard many fun camping adventures about Boy Scouts or family stories. And John loves a good joke, especially a good running gag. You can ask our English teacher, Erin, about how many times and how many different ways John has asked her to grade a particular assignment that he handed in for a class only 1 year late. Or the careful way he works the terrible non-word brung into every class I have with him because of a comment I made one time. But John is also a master of questions. He will ask questions about the material you're teaching in a way that lets you know both that he understood it and he also knows the most off-the-wall way it could be misunderstood. And if there's any free time in your class, beware. You're about to be asked questions like, would you rather have a robot arm or a robot leg? What's the most corn you think you could eat in one sitting? And of course, because he has to be consistent, when you're in school, what kind of lunchbox did you use when you brung your lunch to school? Thanks, John. You've given me a lot to think about, and we'll miss you.
Hello, everyone. My name is Chanel Mulba, and I am a counselor at Vantage. Isaac, we have only known each other for a brief time, but the celebration feels like it's been a long time coming. When I think of you, Isaac, I think of the three recipes for success: goals, effort, and legacy. Isaac had one goal in mind, and that was to graduate. Every time we met, he had a reminder not only from me, but from staff and family that his only focus was to graduate. Thank you, Isaac, for having an open mind and a heart for us to help you accomplish this goal. I know that you do not like to ask for help, but I'm so proud of you for the effort that you have put into your work and allowing us to assist you when needed. Due to you accomplishing your goal and putting in the effort, you have now laid the foundation for your legacy. Mr. Reggie and Mrs. Daphne, thank you for helping Isaac reach this goal.
Struggle is real.
Isaac, always remember that you are smart and you have the right people in your corner rooting for you every step of the way, even me if I'm not present. I am so proud of you, and I believe in my heart that you will have success for the years to come.
Now put your hat on.
Hello, my name is Tom Brokens, and I'm one of the counselors here at Saturday Advantage Academy. This past year was my first year at Vantage, and I was lucky enough to have Joe Stein on my caseload. Joe helped show me the ropes at Vantage and quickly demonstrated an excellent example of what it looks like to be a polite and respectful young man for all the younger students in the building. I always appreciated our wide-ranging conversations that oftentimes involved some very deep thinking, but we also had some laughs thrown in along the way. I will never think of Arby's and the birds are watching the same. I will miss the morning guitar sessions before the school day started, which were just a very small glimmer of Joe's musical talents and abilities that have impressed me throughout this year. Even though school has never been Joe's thing, I couldn't be happier and more proud that Joe was able to accomplish the goal we set out at the very beginning of the year, which was to graduate. Powering through an extremely busy work schedule and those long commutes to and from school. I hope you continue to take your musical abilities and I'm very excited where they take you, and I will continue to be on the lookout for an abandoned Taco Bell for the next music video. Congrats, Joe.
Hi, my name is Katie Beck. I am also a counselor here at Vantage. I get the honor today to talk about two amazing young women who, surprisingly enough, are very, very similar in a lot of ways. The more I thought about Amelia Perez and Zoe Jenkins, the similarities became more and more apparent. They are beautiful girls, both inside and out. They are kind, and they are caring, and they show compassion towards others. Sorry, need a second. I'm getting out of breath. They are very intelligent and work hard, not only in their schoolwork, but also in their jobs. Oddly enough, they both work in animal hospitals and are both considering a career with animals. Zoe is interested in becoming an animal behaviorist, and Amelia, a vet tech. Their compassion shines through in their work with animals. These girls have been through so much throughout their middle school and high school careers. Life has thrown so many obstacles at them, and they have continued to show perseverance and grit. They have grown and matured and done one of the hardest tasks, to work on themselves. They have sprouted into two strong and responsible young women. Amelia and Zoe are silent leaders. They lead by example, by not following the crowd, and by doing what they believe is right, the right thing to do, even when it's the more difficult thing. Author H. Jackson Brown said, "Our character is what we do when we think no one is looking." I can't think of a better way to describe Amelia and Zoe. I'm so very proud of both of you for not giving up and pushing through the hard times. Remember how strong and capable you are when things get tough. And remember that our doors at Vantage are always open. Once a Vantage student, always a Vantage student. Congratulations, Amelia and Zoe. You did it.
Hi, everybody. Congrats to you guys. My name is Desmond Decker. I'm a counselor at Satterton Vantage, and I'm here to talk a little bit about one of our graduates and a student of mine, Dante. I've known Dante since he started SVA as a 13-year-old eighth grader. We've known each other for a long time. He wasn't with us earlier in high school, but for the last 2 years, he's been one of our students. From day one, Dante's always been respectful and caring, and it's been amazing to see him grow and mature to who he is today. A lot of what I'm going to talk about today is mostly Dante's senior year, the last year he's had with us. At the beginning of the school year, Dante was presented with what his expectations were for the year. He would need to pass every class that was on his schedule, a high pressure and stressful situation on its own. Dante took this challenge head on and started the first semester in the best way that he could have, with motivation, perseverance, and all passing grades. Early this spring, Dante was presented with multiple difficult personal challenges all at the same time. Anybody here could easily admit that when you are hurting or stressed or frustrated or tired or overwhelmed, it's difficult to do your job to the best of your ability. Dante unfortunately began to miss some days of school and his grades started to drop under passing. About a month ago, our educational director, Jesse Walsh, and I met with Dante to lay out his expectations to graduate. Because of his grades at the time, he would need to come to school every single day for the remainder of the year, in addition to completing makeup work that he had missed. Dante assured us that he would get it done. So, for the last few weeks of his high school career, I've watched this young man who's stressed and frustrated, grieving, pressured, overwhelmed, and tired come into school every single day, complete all of his work. He showed the same motivation and perseverance I've always known that he's had, but he's done it in a time of his life where I can only imagine how difficult it is to keep pushing and moving forward. Sorry, I lost my spot here. He stayed persistent, he was able to push through to the finish, and now he's a high school graduate. Dante, very proud of you. You should be proud of yourself. I know if you carry the same perseverance and drive, whatever you choose to do, you're going to be successful at it. All of us at SVA wish you the best as you move on to the next chapter of your life, and it's truly been an honor to get to work with you, and once again, congratulations.
Good afternoon. My name is Kate Toussaint, and I'm the art instructor at Souderton Vantage, and I am here to tell you about a very special student named Claudia Tyson. Now, if there were three words I would use to describe Claudia, it would be these. First one is unique, or one of a kind. Her uniqueness was definitely seen in the art classroom. If you don't know Claudia, she's naturally creative. Daily, Claudia would come into class carrying her 20-pound sketchbook and pencils amongst 5,000 other items, including blankets. Who needs a smock when you could just wear a blanket and cover your whole body? Books that were typically not related to schoolwork at all. And a stuffed animal Stitch, which might as well could have been another student in the classroom. It is that large. After spreading her items out over 2 to 3 desks, she would draw all sorts of things, including dragons, anime, and other designs and pictures in her sketchbook. Also, she managed to complete many art projects, including clay, with very long fingernails. Now that's real talent. This year, Claudia took digital photography and somehow included the love of her life, her cat, Mitchell, into every photo homework. Now that's unique. The second word is consistent. When Claudia walked into class, I was confident in knowing what she was going to do every day. Along with the unique items previously mentioned, her demeanor was always positive and she was ready to work. Claudia completed each task with thoughtful brainstorming and reflection, really putting her personality into every single project. Also, her personality was similar in every classroom with every student and staff member. Consistency for you, Claudia, is admirable because you were your true, authentic self with everyone you interacted with, even if it included sarcasm. The last word is strong. I know, Claudia, this has been an uphill battle for you to get to this point, but here you are. You have worked so hard, and it is seen through your success at Vantage. I want to quote you, Claudia, and that I hope it sums up everything that you've learned over the past couple years. You wrote to us in this statement for your final project proposal. I have always viewed mental health as a weakness, but in reality, it is a strength. When you combine all of your gifts, including the uniqueness, creativity, and consistency, with every experience you have been through, this is for all of you, good or bad, you have the potential to move mountains. I am so proud of you, and I hope you know how valued and treasured you are. Congratulations, Claudia.
Last but not least. So my name is Heather. I'm a special ed teacher at Vantage, and I am deeply honored to present the last of this year's farewell speeches to our graduates. I wanted to start by sharing a quote from Eleanor Roosevelt. The future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams. And this goes to all of you. I hope that you all have beautiful dreams of your futures. Now, you can tell from the speeches that have come before me, this entire graduating class is filled with likable young men and women. This group is kind, modest, humble, artistic, and hardworking. But the student I get to speak about has quietly gone about her work without demanding attention or the spotlight, and I appreciate her resourcefulness, her sincerity, and her talent. This student hates to be in the spotlight, and I will try to keep this short. It's my honor to celebrate Lily Broxterman. Congratulations, Lily. Today is a great day. This is the day you've been waiting for since you entered kindergarten 13 long years ago. And time goes fast. Just ask your parents. Does it feel like you just enrolled her in kindergarten? Yeah, seems like yesterday. Well, this ceremony goes fast too. But I want you all to stop and take a moment and think back on everything that you've accomplished. Relish this moment, because now there are infinite possibilities before you. This is the beginning of anything you want. Cherish this moment. Let the enormity of it humble and elate you. Look at what you've conquered. and appreciate what your strength has brought you through. And Lily, I hope you feel proud. We're all very proud of you. I want you to remember how far you've come and have faith in how far you can go. I have faith in you that no matter what road you choose to travel, you will make it your own and you will succeed. You wonder how I know this. I've seen how hardworking you are. You've grown so much socially, academically, and advocating for yourself. It's always been a pleasure to have you in the resource room and to be your astronomy and meteorology teacher. And I can't tell you how happy I was to see you on my student roster. Because you see, this means I could keep track of you and your fashion and your hair color, which was always amazing. Now for you, high school graduation is just the next step in your education. You shared with us that you want to work with children. So soon you'll be headed off to a university or community college preparing for that career you want to pursue. And those future children will be very lucky because you're an extraordinary person. My hopes for you. I hope you keep writing. Your poems and your stories are inspiring. I hope you keep crafting because the items you make are beautiful. And thank you for the personal friendship bracelet lessons. I still could use them, but I at least know what I'm doing now. And above all, remember this. Behind you are all of your memories and past trials, and you conquered them. Before you are all of your hopes and dreams, and I hope you chase every one. I hope you surround yourself with people who love you and know that within you, you have everything you need to succeed. I want you to think of your diploma as a passport and use it well. Congratulations to you. I wish you all the best things that life has to offer.
Thank you, staff, for speaking to what extraordinary young people we have sitting before us. You guys are here. Congratulations. Each of you probably at one point or time, I've talked to you about this moment. I said it's going to be worth it. You're going to feel awesome about accomplishing what you've accomplished and sitting here and celebrating you. And so just congratulations to you all again. Good afternoon. My name is Jesse Walsh, and I'm the Director of Educational Services at Souderton Vantage. We have a very special guest here today who's going to be coming up shortly to present a scholarship to one of our seniors. This is a first for us, so it's a special moment. About a month ago, I received a phone call from Souderton High School inquiring whether we would be interested in learning more about the Dustin White Scholarship Fund. And I said, sure. I was given a phone number, and so I called Darren White, who's sitting here with us today, and we talked about his brother Dustin. And we talked about the scholarship that he's been awarding for the past couple years, and he was looking for a candidate who would fit that profile, similar to his brother. So we're gonna show a brief video here. Please just pay attention, and then I'm gonna have Darren come up and present the scholarship to one of our seniors today. Thank you.
Twenty years ago, I had a major life change that changed the complete course of my life. We lost my brother in 2003, and since that time, I've always had ideas about doing something to keep his memory alive, doing something to kind of leave a positive light on it, a positive legacy. It's meaningful, particularly for me and my entire family, to find someone who's like my brother, and give them a little boost. Give them a little extra help, a little extra something to help them on their path. We wanna find kids that struggle, because we all struggle, but most high school awards go to the scholars, the athletes, the leaders. We are looking for something very different from that. We want everyone. We want everyone to know that they matter and that we care about them. My brother was extremely artistic, and in school he didn't do well. He didn't do well academically. He, you know, ADHD, and just didn't, the teachers didn't know what to do with him. So he was always getting in trouble. And nowadays there's more resources, I think, for people like my brother. I want to do something to impact people's lives. We want the kid you know, who would never win a scholarship, and help him and say, we care about you too. Because that's what my brother needed. And 30 years ago, they didn't have the resources for that. It was a different time. And today, I think as the world changes, we're moving in the right direction, and we're seeing that all kids have different skill sets. Not just the scholars, the athletes, the leaders. We're looking for the disruption in class, because that kid needs love too. We want to hear from the kids and why they think they deserve this award. They write the essay, we read the essays, and then we pick the candidate. We are going to the music room. We're going to the art room. We are going to detention. We want the kids in detention to be a part of this, because that's often the kids that get pushed aside. We're looking for the kids that would not win the award. Being an actor or an actress on stage, whether that's creating music, whether that's pottery, whether that's painting, whether that's sculpting, whatever it is, we want to find these students and we want to give them some help and some resources and some love to help them in their life, on their path, to make their life a little bit better, ultimately to help make the world a better place. Part of my music is making the world a better place. That's what I want to do, because 20 years ago in my life, hit a different track, I knew it's time. I don't know a lot about the butterfly effect, but I'm fascinated with the concept that a butterfly's wings can impact the world in some capacity. So if this scholarship can create just a little bit of a difference in your life for the better, that's what we're doing. That's what it's about.
Thanks, everyone. My name's Darren White. No. Totally unexpected to have emotions today. Like, I thought I was just going to come give an award and leave. So I want to congratulate all of you. I'm so proud of you. My brother would be proud of you, too. If my brother was alive today, he'd be sitting with you. He would be a part of Vantage. He had emotional issues, behavioral issues, academic issues, and I'm so happy to be a part of this. The teachers, the staff, the parents, everyone here who's a part of this makes what I'm doing so full circle, because Satterton High School does a great job, but for years I'm saying to them, you're not picking the right candidate. They naturally just pick the overachievers, and my brother was anything but an overachiever. So this is like exactly what I've been looking for. I just want to thank everyone in this room for being here, and I'd like to present this award to Joe Stein, who, yeah, come on up. I've only known Joe for a short time, but he got to share some of his music with me the other day, and my brother would be so proud of you and all that you're doing. So keep up the good work. I look forward to working with the school more, and follow your dreams. Thank you. Okay, sounds good.
Thank you, Darren. Now I have the emotion too. It was beautiful. Thank you so much. And congratulations, Joe. All right. So now I'd like to introduce to you three individuals who will speak about their thoughts and experiences from this past year. First, they're going to come in order. First is going to be graduating senior Jonathan Fluck. Second, after Jonathan, is Satterton Area High School graduating senior Andreas Cruz. And third is parent of former Vantage student Logan Drakis, Dr. Ken Drakis. Jonathan.
Thank you for coming here all today. I would like to just say my experiences with Vantage and both how it helped me throughout the years and the people who I've met, people who I connected, like the graduating class of seniors. For me, I've been in Vantage for a very long time. About 5-6 years, been in it since I was in middle school. every year, no matter what year it was, no matter what class I was taking, no matter which teacher, it's always been a wonderful experience, meeting new people, talking with either new teachers, old teachers, and just constantly learning. And I feel like the teachers do a really great job in helping not just the entire class, but each individual student with how they teach, the different ways they teach, recognizing the faults in like some people, and then helping them because they know they struggle. For me, my big thing is focus. I've always been bad at focusing. I've always been bad at sitting down for a long time to do one particular, like, let's say an essay, a project. And throughout the years, Vantage has helped me both calm down in doing work, calm down in my own like life and social, so I don't have to like motor mouth, as my family sometimes say. And they've helped me deal with my own individual problems that I have outside of school that I don't necessarily always let it affect at school, but if I'm feeling down, I can talk to my counselor, Chanel, or my previous counselor, Jiyun, before that, about the problems I have at home, my own thoughts and feelings, even during school. And I think that Vantage is just a great school for people who both need help or want help. I think that each teacher are special in their own individual way in how they teach and how they interact with each and every student. Throughout the years, I've known many teachers, simply because I've been here so long. And Dave, Darren, Aaron, Carrie Ann, so many other people, Christian all the way back there. They've always helped me get through like questions I don't know, problems I don't understand, finishing essays, even the one that I turned in a year late. Listen, I lost that on my Google Doc. I swore I sent the hit button. And throughout the years of knowing them and like meeting new teachers like Rachel and Bethany, I enjoy them all. They've always been helpful. They've always been attentive. They've always cared. And to me, I just really love the school. I've been just there for so long. It's going to feel weird not coming in on a Monday morning knowing that Rachel's going to need her cup of coffee, asking how Aaron's progeny is, telling Darren a bad joke that has brung in it. Like, I brung myself here. Talking to Dave about some science thing or whatever, a geeky thing. It's just, I love this school. And I enjoy every moment that I've been here. I enjoy every person I've met. And thank you for letting me come here. It's been a very amazing time. I'm happy to graduate, but I'll forever miss you. I'll always have the memories. For example, I probably won't ever forget the, forgot to turn it in a year late. I'll never forget that. It's just, I hit it. And thank you to Jesse for helping out my senior year, for dealing with my senior project and just helping him out in general. Thank you. Thank you for having me here. Hope you have a nice day, and I hope everything else goes well.
Hi, my name is Andreas Cruz. As they said, I went to Saturday, and I've been invited to speak here, which I'm very thankful for. And if I get emotional, forgive me, I'm incredibly sentimental. So this is big. I know that today is a day of celebration and commending the incredible achievements of the graduates and students at Vantage Academy. So I'll try my best to keep this relatively short. My name is Andreas Cruz. I'm a senior at Saturn Area High School. I'm one of the captains of the Saturn Area Academic Decathlon team, but I was also a Vantage student from 6th to 9th grade. When I tell people this, they're usually shocked, saying things like, oh, but you're so nice. Oh, but you're so well-behaved. There's no way you were sent there. And obviously, at a point, you know, we all have our issues, but I'm glad that I can be a stand-in to show them that Vantage students are not this preconceived notion at all, as everyone here has shown too. They're surprised to define that their conception about what a typical Vantage student looks like is completely the opposite. I came to Vantage because I was struggling with feelings of inadequacy, feelings of anxiety, and feelings of isolation. As a kid, I moved about once a year, meaning that all my friendships, all my achievements, all my progress felt pretty temporary. Moving into middle school is another large shift in my life, which led back to these worries about impermanence that ultimately led to behavioral issues. At first, I thought that getting sent to Vantage was sort of an educational death sentence. I was worried that being removed from kids my age and, you know, that large swath of friends I had would mean socially, educationally, personally, I was pretty much doomed. But, you know, through the years, I've learned that this is entirely not true. Furthest thing from, really. Vantage is not a place to dump problem children to forget about them. It is a place that truthfully and honestly cares about everyone who enters that building. Nobody is left behind, and I am incredibly grateful for that. It is a place where teachers want to see students succeed, where people come to better understand themselves, and where nobody, and I mean this again, I want to emphasize this, absolutely nobody is left behind. What I thought would be a guarantee of failure came to be a launch pad for future success, and I'm incredibly grateful for that. As I come from a family in which many people have not had the fortune or opportunity to graduate beyond college or even high school in some cases, I figured that my emotional issues would seal my fate and leave me feeling regretful and ultimately failed. But now, after getting help from my family, my friends, and other caring people in the world, I can see that it was just a stage of life, one with its fair share of issues and struggles and growing pains, but one that ultimately I could overcome. My experiences taught me that there was no challenge or obstacle too difficult to overcome, and that despite circumstances, the only thing that could prevent me from achieving was my belief in myself and the barriers I placed myself. I grew to be a more well-rounded person, one that was confident in their abilities, and one that knew that there is a whole world out there of people who care, despite what my anxious middle school self thought, all the way back in elementary school as well. These struggles were not the end of my life. In a way, they were the beginning. I know that they have changed me, but they have changed me for the better, not for the worse. I came to high school after my time at Vantage, unsure of what the future held for me, but from what I learned, the people I met, and the skills I made, I never was afraid. I was never worried. I was certain of my abilities, my capabilities, and trusted in the people around me. While I was certain I could ensure I would succeed in everything I did, I learned that I could at least try the very best I could, which led to a high school experience that I thoroughly and verily cherish. I was a member of environmental clubs, I was a member of cultural organizations, I was a candidate for Homecoming King, and I was a captain on an academically competitive team that won a state championship and got to fly out to Texas for nationals as well. I say these things not to brag or speak highly of myself, but to show that even though I was floundering and emotionally struggling at a time in my life, that was not the end of me. I was able to keep pushing forward, and I was able to achieve beyond what I had ever thought possible. And the lessons I have learned obviously will not stop being useful now. They will continue to be useful for the rest of my life. Next year, I'll be one of the first people in my family to go to college, specifically at Ursinus College, study biochemistry, hopefully for medicine, research, and maybe even to come back and be a teacher. And even though there will be struggles and difficulties along the way, I am still not afraid of what the future holds. Because I know that I am capable of anything I allow myself to be, and that there are always people in this world who truly care and will be there to help. Anything is possible, and I mean that wholeheartedly. As long as you put your heart into it, all of you into it, completely, you can achieve absolutely anything you want to. And honestly, to me, for all of us graduating soon, and everyone in this room, the future has never looked brighter, personally. Thank you.
Once upon a time, there was a Chinese farmer had a horse, ran away. Villagers commiserated that evening with them and said, "Hey, that's too bad." Farmer said, "Maybe." Next day, the horse comes back and brings with it 7 wild horses. Villagers all come around that evening and say, "Wow, that's great." Farmer says, "Maybe." The following day, his son is out trying to tame one of the horses, riding it, and is thrown and breaks his leg. Villagers all come around that evening and say to the farmer, that's bad news. He said, maybe. The next day, The conscription officers come around to sign up all the young men to join the army to fight. But they reject his son because he had a broken leg. And when the villagers all came around to say, "That's great news," the farmer said, "Maybe." You know, a lot of times we label our experiences good experiences or bad experiences. And I know as a parent, when we started our journey at Vantage, we had mixed feelings. It was very uncertain. I mean, I remember we were brought into a conference room, and there was all these people in there. There was psychologists, counselors, principals, assistant principals, and then it was us. And I was afraid. There was fear. There was was unknown. And there was even a service dog there that looked a little uncertain. But we started this. We started it, and as we went through school, we could see how things changed. The overwhelming concern and genuineness, the authenticity of the administration and the teachers. And as we got to see how much they cared, then we started to care how much they knew. And then that's when the learning began. And then that's when we started to see changes with Logan and her ability to express himself, to reach out, to learn and to ask questions, to join things, to get outside his comfort zone. And that never would have happened if it wouldn't have been for Vantage. And so I definitely want to thank and appreciate them for everything they've done for our family. Yeah, there's been some bumps in the roads, and we've gotten a few phone calls, but in the end, it's been such a great experience. And as that, you know, going back to that story, you really don't know what happens, whether it's going to be good or bad, and you just gotta go with it. And as far as the graduates, congratulations, and just know that, you know, 10, 15 years from now, you might not remember what some of the things that were said or done, although I guess you'll remember that Google Doc. But one thing you won't forget is how it made you feel. Vantage has made us feel. Thank you.
We have a few more students to recognize and honor before we're done here. And before we do that, I want to take a moment to recognize some students who have completed their program here at Vantage Academy this school year. So the students I'm about to recognize made significant progress through the process of or will be returning to their public school district in the fall. So students, if you are here, I'm just gonna ask you to stand when I read your name, and then audience, if you can just hold your applause till the end, and then we'll recognize these students. The first student is Elijah Armentrout from Souderton. Logan Drakus from Souderton, please stand. Andy Flores Ascension from Perkiomen Valley. Nick McCabe from Souderton, please stand. Megan McCafferty from Springford. And Peyton McDowell from Springfield. Please recognize these students now with me. Well done and congratulations. So now we're gonna take a moment to present some very special awards to some special students. The Student of the Year, the Most Improved Student of the Year, and the Transition Student of the Year Awards. Each of these awards honors those who've experienced significant growth this year as a student, but also as a person and an individual. These individuals set the standard for what it looks like to be the kind of person that embodies our school values of perseverance, character, and hope. Today we will highlight three of these students and their accomplishments. The Transition Student of the Year Award goes to a student who has distinguished themselves while transitioning back to their public school, either part-time or full-time. The Most Improved Student of the Year award highlights a student in our school who experienced some of the most notable and genuine growth over the past year. And then finally, the Student of the Year award goes to a student who has consistently shown integrity and leadership throughout the past school year. So this time I'm going to ask Rachel Gentrin to come and present the Most Improved Student of the Year award. She'll be followed by Chanel Mulba, who will present our Transition Student of the Year and Student of the Year award.
Hi, as Jesse said, my name is Rachel. I am a math teacher at Vantage Academy. There are a lot of great things about being part of the Vantage family. There are great people around you all day, every day, and as you saw, we have a lot of fun. We go on fun trips, have fun parties. It is a great time. But I think if you asked any staff member at Vantage what the best part of what we do is, they would say it's watching our students succeed. It's watching them set goals like graduation and achieve them. It's watching them try things they didn't know they were capable of and experience success. It's looking at them at the end of the year and saying, for the better, you are not who you were a year ago. And that statement is so true of Edwin Zavala. I met Ed as an Algebra 1 student in my math class, and he was not interested in math and happy to let me know that. He often had his hood up, his earbuds in, was watching anime probably, I don't know. And that's who he was at the beginning of Algebra 1. That is not the Edwin you would find walking the halls of Satterton Vantage today. In fact, I was telling Ed, a staff member, about you a couple days ago, and he, a new staff member who wasn't here last year, and he said, no way, not Edwin. But it is, it's true. Ed today greets everyone in the halls with an, oh, hi, insert name here. He grew to be a diligent math student, even if he didn't always like math. He made it on honor roll this year and achieved so much more since I met him at the beginning of Algebra 1. And I think a moment that really captures the growth that I've seen in Edwin was a moment that happened earlier this year as we sat in a meeting and he was presented with a difficult task. Edwin acknowledged that it would be hard, but he said, I'm willing to try it. And then advocated for the things that he needed to be successful in that situation. Ed, I was so proud of you. That is exactly what we hope for each one of our students, that when presented with a difficult task, they think, I can try that. I might even be able to do that. And if I need help, I know how to ask for it. Ed, I can proudly say that you are not the student you were at the beginning of Algebra 1, and I cannot wait to see how you continue to grow and change. Congratulations. Come on.
Hello again. It is an honor to stand before you in this joyous occasion. I am blessed to be in the position of walking alongside our students. But before I announce this award, I want to briefly talk about this student. This student has brought me balanced joy and watching them blossom into the person they are today. I think of our therapeutic relationship as one of a butterfly. As we know, butterflies are beautiful, but before they become these beautiful colored butterflies, they must undergo a process called metamorphosis. Metamorphosis is the transformation of an immature form to an adult form in two or more stages. In terms of a butterfly, they have four stages. The first stage is the egg, the second stage is the larva, the third stage is the pupa, and the fourth stage is an adulthood. The reason I'm explaining this process to you is for you to get a glimpse of this student. This student arrived at Vantage very timid, not sure of the school and how to interact with others. They did not want to be at Vantage and would remain with me for most of the school day. They were mute for the first week until they were felt comfortable and able to build trust with staff. Then once they had that, they began to speak with staff and students. They began to utilize their tools, such as regulating and advocating for themselves and maintain honor roll and growth level. Next, they were willing to take the next step in attending North Monco Technical Career Center part-time and Satterton Area High School part-time. And then for this next upcoming school year, They're looking forward to attending North Monco Technical Career Center full-time in advertising design. The student whom I have the privilege of presenting the Transition Student of the Year Award goes to Logan Drakas. So this award, I had the privilege of working with the student for the past 2 years. The student reminds me of a diamond. Diamonds are known for their extreme hardness, unmatched brilliance, and rich sentimental value. Diamonds are formed due to extreme heat and pressure. This student comes from a hard background and has unwavering resilience that many people would have crumbled in the circumstances with which they were dealt. They have taken stride in overcoming what may have been impossible. In their overcoming, they were able to build waves of connections with staff and students. They have thrived in the safe environment advantage by processing the adversity that they had to endure. In terms of their unmatched brilliance, this student has maintained honor roll and was our growth level 2 student. To be a growth level 2 student, they must demonstrate personal responsibility and independence. This means that the student does the right thing when no one is watching and without reminders. They attend school consistently and regularly and model excellent behavior amongst the student body. This student displays true leadership, character, and integrity. Their rich sentimental value lies in a way that they show staff and students respect, kindness, and compassion. They greet staff and students every morning with a hello and a smile. If any one of their peers lack anything, whether it is food, a pencil, or advice, they are willing to share with them. This student has the responsibility of grooming our sweet dog, Abigail. In the words of the music artist Rihanna, this student shines bright like a diamond. It is an honor to present the Student Award Year to Jonathan Fluck.
Well, thank you all to all the great speakers. And now the moment you've been waiting for, a graduation, okay? So graduates, obtaining a high school diploma is one of the great accomplishments an individual can earn. I congratulate all of you for a job well done. I also want to congratulate your parents again and thank them for allowing us to be a part of their team in helping you experience success. Now I will read the names of the graduates. Graduates, when I read your name, please come forward to be honored. Lily Brocksterman. Isaac Burton. Dante Davis. Jonathan Fluck. Zoe Jenkins. Amelia Perez. Joe Stein. Claudia Stitch Tyson. Before I have the graduates rise, I just want to thank everyone again. You guys are amazing people. And I just want to, I'm just been a privilege to be part of your team. So graduates, please rise and face the audience. Please move your tassel from the right to the left. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the graduating class of 2023. Invited up to say congratulations to the graduates. Thank you again for joining us.